Hi everyone, welcome to ChipRite. In this video, I'm going to explain you how to establish a serial communication between TIVA-C and the ARM Cortex-M4 launchpad board and PC, your laptop or your PC. So it is like not only laptop, you can communicate with any of the microcontrollers also. So it is like with this example, you will be able to understand how not really a simple transmission. Here we will be using reception and then transmission. So basically, we are going to use the interrupt, UART interrupt, and then we'll be receiving some data from the PC, and then based on that, the TIVA-C will be responding messages. So I'll explain you the code. Here we have Code Composer Studio. I'm using version 10 here. So we have the basic header files where we have the in.h, bool.h, hardware.h, memmap.h, hardware.h, and then you have the GPIO if you're going to use some LED indications, and interrupt for using interrupt, and pin map. And then system control .h and uart.h library. So it's basically TIVA-C library. Here we have three messages, that is uart message 1, 2 and 3. So these are the messages like when and receive interrupt is there's a data from the PC which is sent from PC to the TIVA-C microcontroller. Once it is received, the interrupt will be triggered. Then it will check for the data in the buffer, and then based on that data we will have the message sent. So it's like basically we will click on 1, 2, and 3 in our PC system keyboard, and that will be sent to UART, and then the TIVA-C will be responding back. So we have the basic system control settings, so the main clock settings. So if you want to understand about these clock settings, I've already explained on it. Yeah, so I already explained about the clocks in my other TIVA-C videos. You can check for me many other videos in my channel. And now here we have the UART port and module enable. Here in system control peripheral, this getting clocks which has to be enabled for the UART, and then the port. So basically UART is connected, UART 0 is connected to GPIO A, and we have GPIO A to F. And now GPIO pin configuration, it's like A0 is RX and A1 is TX. So now if you just click on this, you will know this. These are the like values are sent to it, and all configured in the library. And then pin type, we have to configure this pin 0, pin 1, and port A. And next, basically it's like if multiplexing the pin, pin type is like it's whether it's a GPIO I2C pin. So it's like one GPIO maybe can multiplex with the different pins like UART, CSP and I2C. So we are configuring this particular pin as UART pin type. And then the basic setting is the UART setting, that is 8 and 1. So 8 bit no parity and one stop bit. So with the 115,200 baud rate, you can change it to 9600 baud rate also here. So you can see 8, 1 stop bit and none parity. So that is what is 8 and 1, and the baud rate is 115,200. So next is we have the interrupt enabling. So the master interrupt enable, and specifically we are enabling the UART interrupt, and then these UART interrupt specific pins also like RX and TX pins, RX. TX. And then next we are writing the main while loop where we have this RX value, which is if we received ASCII 1, that is from PC if we receive 1, we will have this first message will be sent from TIVA-C to the PC, which can be seen. and we are introducing a delay. And then again, next, again, if the value is 2 received from PC, then you send the second message, and value 3, the third message. So next is the interrupt handler. So interrupt handler is, so whenever there is a reception, there's data from the PC, this interrupt control goes to the interrupt handler, and then it clears the interrupt flag. And then, because if interrupt flag will be raised, and that will be cleared, and once it is cleared, we receive the data which is sitting in the buffer through the non-blocking method. So we get the data, and then the data is received in this variable, and that is used here to check which data has occurred, and based on that we will be sending the messages. So whenever you are using interrupt, there's a common settings here. Startup.file. In startup.file, we have interrupt handler, in the startup file you will have to configure the interrupt handler. So you have to add this line here, extend void interrupt handler, or whatever interrupt handler you are going to use, you will have to use that here, and that is the name which is used here. It is the function called interrupt handler name. That handler has to be used, and then what we will have to do is in the reset the vectors, you will have to ISR has to be properly, you can see many ISR here, the fault ISR, NMISR, and interrupt handler, all those things are there. So you will have to properly in the vector table, you will have to properly configure the UART handler. So you can see here that is UART 0 RXTX. Here I have added this UART handler. When you point on this, you can see the function which we have written comes up here, which shows up here. So this has to be added here, and you will have to save it. So once it is the handler is added here, then once you save it, then you go for the uploading of old code. So you'll have to build the code here. So once you build the code, the output file will be generated, which is your test.out file. And once it is done, what you'll have to do is upload the code. So before that, I'll just show you a debug method where you click on debug. In the debug, what we'll have to do is we can place a breakpoint here, place a breakpoint somewhere inside here, this to check whether it is the basic it comes up here inside this while loop during the basic execution, and we will place another breakpoint in the interrupt handler. So already one breakpoint is placed here, so sorry. So what we'll have to do is now you can here we'll not be able to see the RX file, so if you need your properly, because the intro, when we send the data during the transmission from the PC, it has to properly capture. If not, you'll not be able to see the value here. So what we'll have to do is now we will upload the code. We will try to click on resume. So once you click on resume, you can see it hits at this breakpoint, and now we will open the teraterm, and teraterm after teraterm, what we'll have to do is you have to select the serial and the COM port, and then you will have to select the serial port with 115,200, and now I'll just click here with my cursor, and then hit with some character. Now what happens is, let's check whether it comes into the interrupt handler. Now you can see it is getting into the interrupt handler, and then once it is done, it comes back to the control, comes back to the main function, it returns back to the main function. So this is how it works. So now what we will do is terminate. We will upload the code to the board. Now it is done. Now you can see, I'll just clear this. Click one here. You can see sense message that you have says, just you can click on the screen and just click on one, and then that from the keyboard that it, now it is sending a TYC message, that is the first message. Now I will send two from PC, that is I'm switching the like I'm hitting the number two from my keyboard, and now you can see the messages TYC is 2, the second message is coming up. Then I'll hit 3 now from keyboard. Now you can see Tiva is sending TYC received third mess, number 3. So it's like that. So then again 1, and then again 2. So it is like you can try to do these kind of things, and basically you can transmit. You can see UART is used for UART is used by different devices like Wi-Fi, GSM, all those things. You'll be able to send and receive the acknowledgements. So you can basically use this code for that. And this is what I want to explain you in this video. And I'll try to post more videos on different Android platforms. So keep watching. And if you want to know how to create this project, you have my video here in the channel in Chiprai. You can check out other videos of TYC. There you have different types of modules explained. So it will be helpful. And also how to create project is also explained. So we'll meet in another video. Thank you. Thanks a lot.